Nice cup of coffee.
Last night?
Yeah. For him, he got a smile. Nice.
Well, he doesn't get in my face every time I turn around. You know, every time you always try to make it, give me advice.
It's another father-son bonding moment.
He just gets on my nerves every once in a while. How'd it go with...
He thinks it went well. But he doesn't know that we cracked his Humpty Dumpty open and cloned the computer chip inside. What about here in town? Any good news?
They busted Jax last night.
Really? What for?
They picked him up at the airport with a key of heroin in his bag. And now Brenda thinks it's my fault.
She does?
Yeah, go figure.
So the cops think that he's a dealer or just a mule?
Well, I laid out the whole Dorman situation for Taggert. He doesn't believe me. So I got Jason on keep an eye on the wacko doctor. If he makes a move, I'm going to nail him.
What are you, the auxiliary Port Chuckles police force, man? I mean, do they give you a tax break for this or maybe pick up your expenses?
I don't know. It's... How'd it go in Switzerland?
Well, Stefan got a little aggressive when I tried to throw his Easter egg over an Alp. And other than that, it went as planned. Except for one surprise. I saved little Nicholas's life.
Fine, Dad. I got released this morning on bail. Yeah, listen, I just wanted to warn you. May hit the papers today. You might want to do some damage control. Uh-huh.
How much longer is this going to take?
As long as it takes, Miss Jax.
Well, it's just that, you know, they've been looking for 3 hours and they haven't found anything, so...
Well, we haven't started pulling up the floorboards yet. Excuse me.
Trust me. When this is over, the city of Port Charles and the DEA are going to be facing a very large lawsuit. Yeah, I got a pretty good idea who set me up. One guess. Sorry about it, Dad, and I had to handle him. Listen, I got to go. I'll be in touch, okay? Is that the surveillance tape?
You had a meeting here with Dr. Dorman on Friday the 2nd.
He approached me on a business investment, but I never spoke with him here. Why? What does this have to do with him?
Well, excuse the pun, but the doorman said he let him up to this apartment.
Well, he must be mistaken.
Tapes don't lie.
Wait, Dorman came here the other night looking for you.
What did he want?
I don't know. He didn't say. I just got rid of him as fast as I could.
Detective, you got a minute? Found these hidden behind the dresser.
What is it?
Can't be certain without putting it through the lab, but it looks like hydrocodone. Painkiller.
Well, in addition to selling heroin, you're also running a pharmacy.
What are you talking about?
My man found these in your bedroom.
Where?
They had their own little carrying case.
Those are mine. I take them for pain. I injured my hip in an accident.
Did you always hide your pain medication in a compact?
Brenda, don't say anything.
Look, not that it's really any of your business, but I developed an addiction.
Mrs. Jax, I appreciate the fact that you're trying to protect your husband, but...
Listen, the pills are mine. I was in an accident, and my doctor prescribed painkillers, and I became addicted to them. I'm currently in treatment, and I've been clean for almost a month.
That's very commendable. To make sure you stay that way, we'll take these with us. Mr. Jax, I don't have to remind you the conditions of your bail make it a felony to leave town.
Oh, don't worry, Detective Taggert. I'll stick around until I can clear up my name. Then I intend to sue you and everyone else involved in this travesty. Enjoy the rest of your day, gentlemen. What were you thinking? You don't admit to something like that to a police officer?
It's fine. He didn't read me my rights, so nothing I said was admissible.
Yeah, but it was still a foolish thing to do. Brave as hell. Thanks for sticking up for me like that.
You're welcome. Are you going to be okay alone?
Yeah, I'll be fine, but do you have to go straight away?
Yeah, I do. Promise me that you're not going to go after Sonny.
Who are you worried about, him or me?
It makes me really sad that you have to ask that.
I'm sorry. You were really great today. Sticking up for me like that, coming down to court. Reminded me why I fell in love with you.
Promise me you won't do anything stupid.
Promise.
Okay. What was Cassidine Jr. doing in Switzerland?
Well, he was hanging from a cliff when I found him. Came real close to just walking away, letting gravity run its course.
Would have saved you a lot of grief.
Maybe. But, you know, since I was hit by that avalanche back in 82 or 3 or whenever it was, I guess I get sentimental at high altitudes.
Well, you better be careful. If Cassidine finds out that you saved the kid's life, he's liable to put one of those medallions around you.
Now, the other thing he wants around my neck is a noose. So, the cops picked up Jax, huh? Mm-hmm. And they think he's smuggling smack.
No, I doubt it. I think they're just going through the motions. The judge let him loose on bail today.
Does he think you've set him up?
Of course, so I could have Brenda to myself.
You ought to steer clear of her, man. Really, concentrate on Dorman's operation. It'll be a lot less complicated.
You're right.
Hi, Max Scorpio.
You're the police commissioner, Tight?
Well, I figured I'd keep Mac in the loop, you know. Taggart's a loose cannon, that way he can keep an eye on him. So he doesn't screw up the whole thing completely. Who knows, we might even nail Dorman.
Yeah. What? When?
Mac left town.
Well, well, well. If it isn't my favorite gangster. Long time no see, Mr. C.
Shall I have him thrown out?
No, I think you should stick around. Otherwise, I might stick my fist down his throat.
What can I do for you, Detective Taggart?
Your friend Jax has quite the smashing apartment.
You like it? Did you find anything?
Just your girlfriend. Or his wife. Wifeka. I don't know. I could never keep it straight.
Well, if you didn't find anything, why are you still leaning on him? You and I both know. He was set up.
Oh, yeah, I know. Dorman's using him as a stooge. What happened? Did the doctor make a play for Brenda? Or is that why you're on his case, or you just have a thing for doctors?
I don't get this. I hand this thing over to him on a silver platter, and he still doesn't get it.
Not that I don't find this compelling, but I'll be over there if you need me.
Oh, man.
The only thing you gave me is some cockamamie story about some respected doctor at General Hospital who's using his patients to smuggle heroin into Port Charles. Come on.
Did you bother to check it out?
As a matter of fact, I did. The patient who came in from the airport that night in question is a legitimate businessman. He flew in, he had his surgery, he flew home a week later, and as for Dorman, he's so clean he might as well run for president.
Oh, so that's it. You make a few phone calls and you can it? That's great police work there, Detective Taggart.
I was trained by the best. And don't you forget that.
Oh, yeah, Deke. Now I know you're going to crack the case.
Every lead you gave me went nowhere.
What about the kid Matt who OD'd? Did you check where he got his drugs?
I got my man checking his family's house right now and questioning his friends. So far, nobody knows where he got the stuff.
What about the nurse who testified at the trial? Rebecca, I forget her last name.
Chase. Right. Pulled her phone records for the past 6 months. If she called him, She used a payphone.
All right, what about the call Dorman got at the hospital that made him freak out?
The nurse said it was a man's voice. No way to trace it.
Ooh, impressive. What about Dorman?
I've gotten around-the-clock surveillance on him since 0600 this morning, so you, my little friend, I'd better be right about this.
Don't you worry about it, because I know Dorman right now is sitting on a big shipment of grade-A heroin that he can't move because his pal, Harry, is dead. But my guess is the people who fronted the shipment are getting a little nervous because they want their money, and if they don't get their money soon, they're going to be upset. So he's got to make a move now.
Then we will bust him. Now, is there anything else I can do for you, Mr. Corinthos?
Yeah. Why don't you explain to me, if you're following all these leads, why are you still busting Jack's chops?
Maybe you're not as smart as you think you are, Mr. Corinthos. The more we keep the heat turned up on Jack's, the more Dorman's going to think he's in the clear, the more confident he gets, the sooner he'll make a mistake, and then we can take him down.
Ho! If I'm not mistaken, I think you just said something very intelligent, and you're trusting me with your confidence. Why?
Worry about it. Take your mind off that lousy love life of yours.
Luke's, Mike speaking.
Yeah, is Sonny there?
Who's asking?
This is Jackson. I just got an answer to my question.
Hi, Luke. I'm looking for Sonny.
It's not a real good time. Nice to see you too, Brenda.
You need to help Jax.
I already told the police Jax was set up. There's nothing more I can do.
I don't believe that.
What do you want from me, Brenda?
Well, I mean, you have an organization, right? That means you can find out anything that you want.
What do you think I've been doing for the last 2 months?
I just want you to remember that Jax is the one who pulled you out of that cave. He saved your life. You owe him.
No, I don't owe him. You know, but I've given the police everything I have.
Well, they still think something's going on. For the last 3 hours, they've been tearing our apartment apart. They have the place staked out. I mean, they're treating Jax like he's some kind of drug kingpin.